up, Cardinals fans? Good morning, St. Louis. I hope you all have plenty of coffee to help you recover from the last couple of days. First things first, congratulations to the Stanley Cup champion, St. Louis Blues. What a week it has been already. If you don't know me, I'm Tara Wellman. I do not cover the Blues, but I do cover the St. Louis Cardinals, the other team in the St. Louis area that's sort of been under the shadow of the incredible run to the Stanley Cup championship for the hockey team in town. But I do cover the Cardinals for birdsontheblack.com and right here on YouTube. So subscribe to this channel if you're into that sort of thing. And my nails are blue for the Blues, so I can do both. But grab that coffee of yours, because the Cardinals have been playing while the Blues have been doing their thing. And last night, they took on the Mets in New York City. A homecoming of sorts for Harrison Bader, the Cardinals center fielder. Let's talk about what happened last night. First things first, Harrison, how's my hair look on TV? Or YouTube, TV-ish. How's my hair look? If you missed the tweet, Harrison Bader was pretty excited about playing in his hometown and showing off in front of all the haters that said he'd never make it. Well, the showing off part, at least Harrison Bader, played along. In the Jacob deGrom game, though, you expect everything to be a little more difficult offensively. But a little more difficult offensively for these Cardinals as of late basically means a shutout. So when the Cardinals actually scored first last night, I almost didn't believe it. But the Mets are kinda bad, so maybe that counteracts the deGrom factor. Not really. No. At least not until much later when the Mets really out-Mets'd themselves. But we'll get to that in a moment. Anyway, hometown Harry picked up the first hit for the Cardinals, a double, and followed it with a stolen base, showing off those lovely locks, and then he scored on a Matt Carpenter base knock. Now, Cardinals starter Jack Flaherty apparently still doesn't seem to believe in shutdown innings, and twice last night, he gave up runs immediately after the Cardinals scored. Buddy. Pal. The first Mets runs came in that third inning on a two-run homer by Michael Conforto, with two outs, by the way. Flaherty just cannot find his put-away pitch consistently. After Paul DeJong answered with a solo shot of his own in the sixth, Flaherty, who did have eight strikeouts on the night, gave up three consecutive hits and a walk before giving way to Giovanni Gallegos. The run that scored on the following sac fly was also, of course, charged to Jack Flaherty. That makes four on the night, all coming in the innings immediately following the Cardinals getting on the board. That same sac fly, though, turned into an inning-ending double play when, again, Harrison Bader launched a rocket to Matt Carpenter at third, who flipped the ball to Colton Wong, who, surprise, had trailed Todd Frazier all the way around the bases, dropping the tag right on the base for the out by mere inches, if that. So that was fun. But that appeared to be that. The anemic Cardinals offense was not able to muster much more in the way of riveting scoring chances. But then, the heavens opened up and the infield became a soupy mess. The grounds crew began to roll out the tarp, but the Mets players apparently lobbied to keep playing and won? I mean, I get that they only needed three outs as it was the top of the ninth inning and they were up by two runs, but since when do players get to argue with an umpire's decision and win? Also, they might not want to try that again. Because it still took a good 10 minutes before the field was even remotely playable, and that's a bit questionable. And even then, Colton Wong had to pull up on a surefire RBI double, and Bader slipped all the way onto his back trying for third on the RBI knock that tied the game. Did I bury the lead there? They tied the game after the Mets whined their way into playing the inning. I mean, is there any other way for that story to end? Or it could just not end, because that is the story, and then it just got put on pause. It was bedtime, so we just closed the book, we'll finish the rest of the story tomorrow, even though you can't wait to see how that is the story, because it did not stop raining, and the Cardinals and the Mets will conclude that game, starting with the bottom of the ninth inning in a tie game, today, before playing their regularly scheduled game with Daniel Ponce de Leon on the mound for the Birds. No, I am out of town for a couple of days, and I hope to have some great games to recap for you when I get back. But for now, we'll see how this one ends. And I'll see you later.